We moved in.
Here. Really? Well, I've been driving for 4 hours.
Well, I'm tired.
Yeah.
Well, all I can say is that we can get you to relax a bit now, and we'll try and make it as easy as possible. The more we can find out about what we can do this afternoon, the less I have to make you do it.
It's not a question of what we're supposed to
do. I know, it's the
idea of coming out here. Jesus Christ, you know, I don't do this kind of traveling when I'm home. And then they get lost on top of it.
Well, they shouldn't do. He knows.
Driving around. Oh, Christ.
They shouldn't. I don't even know. Or have we? How are you, Carl?
Terry had a break, please.
Well, anyway, now we're here.
Yeah,
would you like a drink or something to eat? Or?
No, I'd like to go get with this thing and find out what it is you want to do. That's why I'm out here at this hour.
Yeah, well, let's go in your room. Why don't you sit down comfortably? Yeah, we'll go in his room and sit down quietly and work it out.
You will quote me as saying, "I'm unhappy."
Okay, let's go to your dressing room. Go this way. Well, the thing is that we do two shows which are the duration of 24 and a half minutes each. They're transmitted as separate entities, so we can record them as part one, have a break, take it easy for 20 or 25 minutes while we give a drink to the band and so on, do the second one, and that's it. We start at 8 o'clock. There's an audience of about 700 in that hall, and we should be through by 9:30. I would think in that sort of time, knowing the sort of lengths that you play, but as you were saying yesterday, you may vary the lengths, you know, from what is on record to what is on concert.
Depends upon entirely what we're going to play.
Yeah.
And I hadn't thought too much about it, because when we do a thing like this, we do a show like this, we usually just take it from the top, change of moods and pace,
and
sometimes four tunes can run a half hour, sometimes one tune can run a half hour, depending on how it's going.
Well,
you've heard the albums, right?
Mm-hmm.
What tunes would you like to do?
Well, as I was saying to you yesterday, the stuff on the latest album available here, there's, you know, in a half hour of tunes from that album, you can get through about three or four, and that's about it.
That's right.
As far as your new stuff, which we don't hear yet over here, the album you say that is currently about to release.
It's be released, what's today's date?
25th.
It's released today.
Yeah, well, we haven't got this here. No. Liberty haven't got this album yet.
No, you won't have it here till December. There's so many things, you know.
Sure,
there's so many groovy things to be done. There's so many groovy things to be done.
I don't want to over-coordinate it, because I could do it, but I mean, it's pointless doing material which won't be shown, because we've got to come down to what is our allocated transmission time eventually, so there's no point in taking 11 numbers when we only want 5 or something, you see.
Let's get 5 numbers with a thing like, we had a very groovy arrangement of Green Sleeves, which runs about 4 minutes. I think it would be a good opening, because it's strong. It's a good, strong opening.
It's rather a nice idea, if I may explain. This place is the cultural home of a composer called Benjamin Britten, who's he's our major serious music composer. And the whole tie-up with Green Sleeves being a traditional English tune and Benjamin Britten is rather a good one.
Right.
You know,
always
a nice idea. Yeah.
Always
think.
Always
that's
think.
What it's about.
Right. That's what it's all about. See that? How did I know that?
How did you know?
TV studio, you guys.
When do we eat?
Thank you.
Here we go, West Side Story.
Let's give it a go.
Cut out the drum solo. Where can I put this?
Right here.
Want some? Want some? Hurry up. You got it all over yourself.
Sorry, it's not the main.
Oh.
As you take it, buddy, anything as you like.
Okay. Well, I'll sit over here. And, it's kind of difficult to even get into the thing. The fact that I've been in the band business about, 35 or so years, having played with some of the best bands in the States, Tommy Dorsey, Artie Shaw, Bunny Berrigan, Harry James. I think I've recorded with just about every important jazz star that ever created. Charlie Parker, Lester Young, Count Basie, Dizzy Gillespie, Miles Davis, and right down the line, the greatest improvisers that I think the world's ever known. And I've been fortunate to have been chosen to play along with some of these people. I think playing makes me tick. I've been doing it for so many years that it's now the most important part of my life. The fact that every day is another challenge to me. The music is a challenge because when the band first organized, everybody thought that a big band would see a chance because of the kind of music that was being played, the pop things. But I feel that there's always a place for good music, and this is the challenge to me, to prove to the young people that the big bands are really not dead. They're more alive now than they ever were. There's no other business in the world like the music business, because you're doing the thing that you love to do, number one. You get a chance to see the world, number two, and you get paid for having fun. What could be sweeter than that? And that makes me tick. What else makes me tick? Meeting new people. The fact that you have to drive 150 miles to do a television show makes me tick. Sometimes my wife becomes a little upset that I'm on the road as much as I'm on the road. But that's her problem, actually, because I always ask her to travel with me. But she likes to stay home. We have a lovely home in Las Vegas. And she was here with me on my first tour. And then when we came back here the other day, she wanted to come, but then she decided to stay home. And that is a drag. But then, of course, this is my business, and I love my business more than anything else. This is the thing that keeps me going. Not too sure, are you? I thank you for that nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome you here this evening to this prison camp. That's the thrill to play here tonight, and we're very excited about being chosen to be the first jazz band to represent this new series for the BBC. We hope that some of the things we've chosen to play for you tonight, you'll dig. If not, tune in next week. Something's bound to happen. The first thing we play will be a brand new arrangement that we're going to record next week at Ronnie Scott's Club in London. It's a brand new arrangement of a thing called Greensleeves. How about that? Are we going to play that first? Where's the drummer? Oh, that's me. I'll see you in a little bit. Okay.